morning class. We have been going to go with the same lesson number 3 from the previous 3-4 classes. We have been dealing with the same lesson. So today probably we will be going to get at the end of this 3rd lesson.
Equinoxes. This is very important. So what is meant by equinoxes?
throughout the world, the day and the night are in equal distribution, like 12-12 hours. So March 21st and September 23rd, it is being throughout the world, not only in our country, throughout the world, the days and nights are being equal, so that is known as the equinoxes. Now next one, as we move further towards the north and south poles of the tropical region, the northern poles and the southern poles, we reach a region where it gets warmer in summer but also very cold in winter. This is the temperature zone. So here we are going to show you the what are the different kinds of temperature belts and what are the different kinds of temperature zones. The northern portion of this region gets snowfall in winter. If you move further to the north or south or this temperature belt, you will reach the polar region. This region are very peculiar. This region is away from the sun during the winter month and does not get any sunshine in the day. That is, for 6 months there is no sunshine in the polar regions, and the next 6 months it constantly doesn't throughout the 24 hours. There are no nights or darkness. A place which has 6 months of a day and 6 months of night, even during the day, it gets very slanting rays of the sun. The sun does not rise high in the sky, but only stays above the sunrise point, that is the horizon. So it never gets very hot. So for the 6 months, it is freezing cold. So the cold that the entire ocean, the Arctic Ocean, remains frozen throughout the year. So cold that the soil became frozen like a hard rock, and roots of the trees cannot penetrate. Penetrants which cannot able to have the capacity to grow because the complete soil is being frozen, and the frozen it is so hard that it doesn't allow the soil to be melted up with the ice, and definitely it is not been possible the roots to get shoot up that water and to get grow. So trees just cannot grow in this region. When the sun appears for 6 months, the snow melts, part of the sea also melts. Some plants like mosses, lichen and some flowering plants grow. So here we can have a figure of this 3.5, how it is been given, the northern light which is been falling in the northern parts of the hemisphere. Even though it has been throughout the summer season the sun rays, but still it is been only in the horizon. It is in the sun rays which is been depending, and due to that also it won't be that much of a hotter climatic condition. So what does this figure say, 3.5? Northern lights visible in the northern polar region occur during the seasons when the sun does not rise above the horizon. So this is what we have been done with this third lesson. So I'll just be giving about this temperature belts from the earth, the two mind mappings which will be very easy for you to understand, and now I'm just going to give a glimpse on that two mind mappings of this temperature of the belts, and it will be easy for you to understand what is meant by equinoxes, to which area, what are the temperature belts, how it is been going to be done, all this one. Now I'm going here, the very first is about the temperature belts on the earth. I'll be just leaving out here. Temperature belts on earth. grace. Then next it is on equal March 21st and September 23rd. This is what we call as these two dates are being known as the equinoxes. Equinoxes. So this is what about the temperature zones, and the other hand is giving what is meant by temperature belts. What is meant by temperature belts in the Tropic of Cancer is what, Tropic of Capricorn, what, so which places, what it is going to deal with that one. So basically, I'll just give once again the factors affecting the seasons. First is the curvature of the earth, second is the rotation on its own axis, then the revolution again 365 days, it itself rotates, then again in the same, its orbit path which has been going to rotate and having a tilt position from the North Pole to the South Pole, slightly tilted. We cannot see out from our navel, only it's so set and so like, example, the leaning tower of Pisa, instead of standing straight, it's completely little bit slanting up. Next is tropical belts, divisions, like first is horizon. Horizon is complete line indication which above it raises, not below to that one. The next is tropical zones. So out of that tropical, the zones, how many are things? Tropical zones, temperate zone and polar zones. So these sun rays which has been falling on which particular zones? June 21st is Tropic of Cancer. March 21st to September 23rd, it will be on the equator. And 22nd, it will be on the Tropic of Capricorn. Next, 21st of September to this 23rd September, means throughout the equator, this equator regions, these two dates is known as the equinoxes. Throughout the world, the day and night shall be equal. Now, it is going to have the what is the temperature, different kinds of the belts which has been existing on the complete the earth. Temperature belts. The polar meadows between Sierra is a cold polar region civil. It extends from the Arctic Circle. Arctic and Antarctic circles.
The notes part of this one, I'll be just giving you the worksheet. And next in tomorrow's class, I'll be giving up fourth lesson, introduction, what are the things, what is been going to read about this one. Thank you.